Hey, how's it going? I'm Nate from GCP Comics, and today I'm going to be continuing this watercolor painting that I started the other day. Previous videos, the pencils are out there, and then the first flats layer, and then I kind of overworked it a little bit later on that day. So I'm going to try to touch it up. Once I start to hit the background with a little bit dark, I'm hoping it'll pop the figure forward. We'll see how it goes. So it'll be watercolors today. I do have some watercolor pencils as well, just in case I decide to use those. Kind of even it out a little bit in areas as well. Sometimes those are nice to layer. See how it goes. So I'm going to start by trying to darken the sky. I'm just going to go into the sky and mix up like a purplish. Alright, so first step is just coming up with the color for the sky, and then I'll start to lay it in. Alright, so right now I'm just laying in a first quick layer. So I'm adding like brown into it to darken it. Hopefully it works. I'm gonna test it up in the top real quick. Get a little bit more. So just building up more layers, trying to overtop the gray that I already had under there. I think I need just the perfect amount there. I'm about to run out, so. Bring it into the foreground as well. So now I want to go into the sand area or like the middle ground. I'm going to add, I want to cool it down some more. This was a little bit too warm, I think, still. I like it. I'm going to still add to it, darken it some more. Smoke, it's going to be flames. Hopefully I can get it to work correctly, but we'll see. And I just dripped some right in the middle, didn't I? Oh well. Fix that too. Alright, so I'm gonna now go for right, so now I'm going to try to hit some of the shadows, the darker parts, into the sand areas, the sand dunes. I did mix up more of a blue for the darker shadows. It will get some of the reds for the like highlights, so the flames will be in this area, and I'll do some reds going throughout it too. But this one's going to be mainly shadow. If it's dark enough, I might have to go back in. Oh, there we go. So just more just moving around the water a little bit. So it'll have a couple layers, I'm sure, of highlights and shadows. There will be some white added at the very last step to build it back up. Drop a little bit more of the wet on wet. Let the gray, like the shadow, kind of move around a little bit more organically. See what happens. So I'm trying to darken the background to make him pop. I went a little bit dark, I felt like, on him, but maybe he'll start to come back out a little bit as I go darker in the background. So working on the sky, working on the background. I'm gonna have to let it sit for a minute, unfortunately. Let it dry for a second before I can add another layer. We'll mix up something different over here. Actually, grab the black. I don't want black. I do not want to use. I'm trying to avoid black until I just do like the line work on top of it. Haven't decided. I'm gonna try to paint it, make it painterly. We'll see. I don't really paint that often, so this is kind of all me just trying to get better at things I don't do. Right, the two-hour grind. That's kind of why I'm doing it. Keep creating. Spend a couple hours working with things I'm not really sure. Yes, I've used it. Yes, I know how to use them. I just don't do it enough. I don't have the patience usually to sit there. I like to just sketch stuff and onto the next sketch, onto the next. So we'll see how this goes real quick. Maybe I got it dark enough this time. Hopefully. And a little darker. Touch more red. Did it darken them? Nah. Maybe a little bit. We'll see when it dries. So just working on trying to add layers, build it up a little bit. Still letting the sky still wet actually a little bit, so that's still drying. The sand is still drying. I'll just put my hand in it, but that's alright. So I'm trying to work on his body while that's happening. And just another layer of the dark. Alright, so he's been battling for a while. He's a little beat down, covered in blood a little. Just adding more shadow. There's gonna be a big fire behind him. causing destruction. Always liked this character design when I was a kid, so thought I'd try it out. Never drew him before, so this was my first attempt at that, and never painted him before, so, you know. And that same tone, same shadow tone in the, I don't even know, loincloth, I guess? That's not really a cloth. I don't know what this is called. Even his armor. It's not even armor, I don't know. Hide. Yeah, there it is. Some hide. Fortunately, watercolor takes time. I gotta kind of let it dry in between steps, and still got some areas that are a little wet from the previous run. Trying to do what I can, jump around where I can without affecting too much of the overall. And not put my hand right smack in it and smear it or something. Gonna cause it to dry lighter though, so Might look darker now. Might be temporary. Alright. Making some progress. Never played Dungeons and Dragons either in my life. Sure, it's pretty fun. It looks pretty fun nowadays. They've been doing some pretty cool stuff with it. Alright. Making some progress on this Warduke today. Looks like my camera's second behind me now. Moving too fast. Darken the inside of a shield still, right? That looks a little bit off, a little bit light. It's pretty close, only a second behind now, but it's gonna slow down again, I'm sure. So let's see, I want to go with blue in the shadows, right? Some more purple actually. It's gonna be lit up, the backlight's gonna be the red fire, and so some cool colors in, so it'll be more of a bluish purple for like the shadows is what I'm going for. Some areas it was more of the reddish brown, depending on what's where the light's hitting and things. So the inside of the shield's gonna get more shadow than the outside would, right? So, or less of the flame light hitting inside, so it'll get a little bit of the purplish as well. I want to go back over to the blue. I'm going to take some of this red that I already mixed and add it to that blue. So it should be a more of a purple, but like a cooler purple. Or maybe it won't. We'll find out in about a second. So let's see. Oh, yeah. darken in there, but I'm gonna have to go back over it again. Making some progress. I haven't used black yet. I can't decide. I'm gonna probably do the line work, like I normally will with the ink marker pen, and it's gonna pop the figure out, I'm sure. But try to avoid it and try to see how much of it I can do without the heavy outlines. Like my lines are still there from the pencil, and I can still see them. But trying to just to do it with more of the light and dark with the paint. Seeing what I can do there as well. So just testing different things that I don't usually do while I'm practicing some watercolors. Trying to switch it up a little bit. Always looking for my next ideas too, so if anybody wants to see something or a technique, feel free to message or send a comment, and I will get to, you know, different techniques, different things, you know, marker stuff again, or digital, whatever. I kind of work in everything a little bit. They're all very similar, at least for me. I use them all the same kind of way. But any tutorial type of stuff, I can always try to help out. I know these aren't quite as exciting or as engaging. Hey, I'm mixing, you know, a little bit of brown, a little bit of red, a little bit more blue to it, you know, switching it up to make the purple. So get all the steps, all the steps that are involved. All right, see if I can get this a little bit darker in the shield. Bum, bum, bum. Warduke. Advanced Dungeons & Dragons, old school 80s cartoon. If I was quicker than I am, I'd pull it up and have a window already ready to play it, but cue that. Check it out, look him up. Ridiculous. Probably terrible, I haven't rewatched it. They released like the Hasbro did a whole line of like the old cartoon figures, and then NECA got like the Grimsword and the Warduke and released those, and they were pretty rad, so that's what led to this picture being painted. Looking at those, trying not to buy one. Alright, I'm gonna go a little bit darker now into his straps, armor straps, whatever they are. Hit the belt real quick first with the same color.
Whether or not a person is happy
go with the darker than this one. I don't really even use this green palette. I'm just going to get that out of the way. Didn't use any of the greens. Put my finger right in the blue, and then I'm gonna touch the paper, right? So I'm gonna have to try to. It'll be alright. Let's see how this turned out real quick. Looking pretty dark. Let's keep going. A little bit more on there. Right. I'm thinking he's looking pretty good so far. I don't know. Maybe, maybe not. But, so he's got his foot up. He's pulling his sword out of a body. It's hard to tell. That's what this is right here. Possibly. I don't know. Or it's just another dirt mound. Either way. I gotta hit the gauntlets, boots, sword, armband, a couple more of the gold areas with some shadows. Then I gotta revisit the background for another layer. Which I will probably do the background next. Let's see, I can just... Alright, so I am still working on this piece. Just adding layers upon layers of watercolors on. I'll get this to curve a little bit. There we go. Trying to make it kind of like there's going to be a fire behind him. It's going to be backlit. And yeah, this is where I'm about where I'm at. Still have to go in and add some blacks at the end. Well, blacks and then some white acrylic paint pen on top. Do a quick layer in the sand, I guess. I don't even know what it is, actually. Didn't really draw it out, just kinda. Maybe I'll make a couple buildings or something, I don't know. Yeah, just the ground. Yeah. Cool. That would have been a disaster. Thank you. So he kind of blends, but he's getting there. So, see if he looks any better up close. You lose some of it, I guess. The lighting. But he's getting there. Thank you. right. Getting there. I'm liking it. I'm liking it. I don't know. Hopefully, you guys are liking it too. And if you are, and you stop by, and you're catching us later on YouTube or anywhere else, give us a like, give us a follow on those jams. We appreciate any support, even if it's just a like, you know, just a follow. It's all good. I appreciate everything. So, still working on this Warduke. I'm just adding layers. Started to do the fire in the background, moving up and down, around, all over, so I don't wipe my hand into a wet spot. So, getting closer. A couple more layers, I think. Got to get that sky. I want to start to do the gray coming down from the top into it, and bring some more red into the purple, I think, near the bottom. And then, yeah, hit him with a little bit of the red fire light. You know, I want it to like kind of look like he's got a backlight from the fire, so he's going to be get a little bit of that coming around his form as well. So I'll just take like through it just like this. Probably wasn't quite ready for it yet, but something like that where it's just like a solid red. Just to do the line work a little bit. So I'm trying to give him that, like, looks like he's actually got the light, you know, the light source is behind him. He's glowing, walking out of the fire. I haven't quite finished it yet, of course. I'm just starting it, but that's what I'm going for at this point. So you really want, like, a dry brush to get like a thicker opaqueness with like watercolors, you know, less water, more paint, it'll be darker. More water than the paint, and you'll get the opposite, right? It'll be more transparent. This is a tough angle to get to. All right, making some progress. Still grinding away, 2-hour grind. Some watercolors today. I'm gonna jump back up into the sky now. I'm gonna add like a darker. Now I'm gonna get into a little bit of the black. I'm gonna add some black into that purple and try to bring some more of the heaviness behind it. See how it goes. Back to a big brush. I haven't even started this character in the background either. Whoops. I think I'm going to just silhouette him a little bit more. It'll just be like a darkish brown with a red highlight, probably. Thank you. All right. Getting pretty close, I think. This still looks too light over here. Clear it out a little. All right. So on today's 2-hour grind, it's going to be one more session, I think, for this to be finished. I do want to take some fresh eyes at it. I don't want to keep working on it and overwork it. I am going to take a little break from it for the day. I'm going to call it on that, but tune in next time on the 2-hour grind tomorrow. I'm hopefully, you know, I usually start at 3, right around 3 to 5. If anybody wants to hop on Twitch or YouTube, give us a like, give us a follow. If you enjoy this content, if it's something that you want to know, I don't talk a whole lot unless, you know, if there's something that you guys want to know, please reach out, let me know, and I can handle or, you know, give you my best advice on certain things. I don't always know it all, and I only do my things my way, right? That's why we like to watch other artists, lots of different artists, take in what they got, you know, pull a little bit from here, pull a little from there, and try to figure that out. But thanks for tuning in to the 2-hour grind. I am Nate, and I appreciate it. Give us a like, give us a follow. Thanks.